Hello and welcome to Everyday Matters. How are you today? I hope you're well and I hope you're keeping safe. So today I'll be talking about six reasons why he cheats, even though he claims to love you, even though he claims that he's so in love with you. And this is a question that I've struggled with for such a long, long time. Is it possible to love someone and still cheat on them? Is this in any way possible? I would really love to know your thoughts, so please leave them at the comment section and I'll be more than happy to look into them. Welcome back to Everyday Matters with Tari. I'm here to give you lifestyle advice and tips to help you live your dreams, achieve your goals, and become the best version of yourself. Now, if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do and click on the notification icon so you don't miss out on any of my updates. Okay, so now straight to the topic of today. When we talk about cheating, it's not just peculiar to men. We know that women also cheat, so cheating is applicable to both men and women. But I have another question. Who do you think cheats more in relationship? Is it the men or is it the women? Guess what? According to the General Social Survey carried out by University of Chicago Independent Organization, 21% of men would cheat, okay? And 10 to 15% of women will cheat. So which means that both men and women do cheat. Again, I don't believe this is acceptable. I don't believe that cheating is acceptable in any way. Whether you are a man or you are a woman, I don't think it is acceptable. How can you say you love someone and still cheat on them? Love is not just a feeling, it is a choice. Okay, so when you love someone, it means that you choose to love them, you choose to be with them, you choose to respect them, you choose to honor them, you choose to protect them, to protect their feelings, you choose to be committed to them, you choose to be connected to them deeply. Okay, so it's not just a feeling because we know that feelings do come and go. Feelings can change from one minute to another or from one day to another. Our feelings can change. So love is not a feeling, it's a decision. It's a conscious decision that you take to be with someone, to love someone, to honor that person, to respect them, and not to hurt them. So why would you now say that you love someone and still cheat on them when you know that this thing you're doing is going to hurt them, it's going to make them feel bad? Why do it? So how is it possible to have to even claim that you love someone and you're still cheating on them? The reason why I struggle when I hear people say you can love someone and still cheat on them, I struggle really, really hard because how can you decide to love someone, to respect them, to protect them, and still hurt them at the same time? It's not even possible, which means that you're changing from loving them to not loving them from one minute to another. Okay, and I know that the number one reason why someone cheat is not because there's anything to do with you. It's not because you're not good enough or you've done something wrong, but the number one reason is because that person has a character defect. Okay, so they have a character defect, so that is the reason why they would choose to hurt you, knowing that what they are doing is wrong, knowing that what they are doing is going to hurt you. They go ahead and do it. And what happens when you cheat is it breaks relationship, it breaks the trust in relationship. So, and this trust, sometimes you can rebuild it, sometimes it can take a long time to rebuild, sometimes it can never be rebuilt. So why would someone know that this thing I'm doing is going to cause a crack in my relationship, it's going to break this person, it's going to cause a problem in my relationship, and still go ahead to do those things? Okay, only because they have a problem, because they have a defect in their relationship, they are out of character. That is the only reason why they will go ahead and do that. But two reasons why men would cheat on you is because they know they can. Okay, a lot of times people men cheat because they know they can do it and get away with it. Okay, and they feel like, okay, I won't get caught, or maybe my friends are doing it, therefore I can do it. So peer pressure is another reason why people would cheat. So if they're surrounded by people that do it, people that cheat, so if their friends cheat, they would also go ahead and cheat. They know that, okay, my friend does it and he doesn't get caught, or my friend does it and nothing happens, therefore I think I can do it as well. So they go ahead and do it because they can. They do it, some people do it because of the fun of it. Okay, and it's really, really bad. What you want to do is think about the effect that it will have on your partner. Think about the effect that it has in your relationship when you do it. What if they find out? I know that you're doing it as a man, you cheat because you think that you can, and because you think that you won't get caught. What if your partner finds out? How will they feel? What happens to your relationship at that time? So that's one thing you want to be thinking about when you're cheating on your partner. Third reason why men will cheat is because you accept that behavior. You accept them with those behaviors. That's why they'll go ahead and cheat on you. And if you accept them, then why would they not cheat anyway? Okay, so if you accept, if you think this thing I'm doing is okay, then why would I stop doing it if it's okay by you? Okay, so the reason why men cheat is because it's accepted. So they do this thing, they come to you and say, oh, I'm sorry. You accept them, they do it again. it's come back to you. They say they are sorry, and it keeps going on and on and on and on, and you just keep accepting it, then they would not change. They will keep doing it. A lot of times, the reason why a lady would accept a man that cheats on her is because they have said, you know what, this is my last bus stop. Probably they've been through relationships that have hurt them, that they've met with people that have hurt them, they've been through one bad relationship or another. Therefore, they feel like, you know what, I'm not going anywhere, this is where I'm going to. Whatever happens here, I'll just take it, I'll just accept it. And some guys also make them feel that way, like, okay, this is your last bus stop, I love you, so you're not going anywhere. Introduce them to their families, get introduced to the girl's family, they introduce the girl to their family, and the girls feel comfortable, like, okay, this is the person I want to be with. And that gives the guys the opportunity to go out, like, okay, you know what, you'll always be there, you are my number one. And these guys feel like, you know what, whatever I do, she'll always be there, she'll forgive me anyway. So if you know this person has a good heart, this person would love you and forgive you, then why do you go ahead and keep hurting them in that way? Leads me to my fourth point, which is the fact that you do not have value for yourself, okay? You never have value for yourself, therefore a guy will cheat on you. So what you want to do as a lady is have value, know your limit, know your line, draw your lines and say, you know what, this is what I can take in a relationship. I can take this in a relationship. I can take a guy that cheats on me. If you know your values, and the guy would respect your values. If you don't have value, he's not going to respect your values. He will do whatever he wants because he doesn't know if he's acceptable by you or not. So you want to have values. And I know that this can happen a lot of times when maybe you've been through a relationship that have not worked, or maybe from your background, you've experienced things that have been that way. Maybe your family, maybe your mom went through a relationship that's her husband was cheating on her, or things that have happened in your family, in your background, in your environment. All this go a long way to affect the way we behave in our relationships as well. But as a lady, as a woman, you want to have values. You want to be able to draw the line to say, you know what, this I can take this, or this is what I can take in a relationship. It is very important that you have value for yourself. So you need to know that you deserve better. You deserve a man that will love and respect you enough to know that, you know what, I can cheat on my woman. I can't cheat on this girl because I love her too much. And the fifth reason is the fact that the person you are with is just immature. He's just completely immature. So no matter what you do, he's not going to change. Say, for instance, you decide to go out, or you decide to date someone that is a player, or someone that's a Casanova. My dear, you've just signed up for heartbreak. You've just signed up for problems in your life and in your relationship. Because no matter what you do, no matter how much love you show to him, he would not stop. He would never stop cheating on you. Okay, so you want to stay away from someone that's immature. Or if, for instance, you didn't know he was immature and you got into a relationship with this guy, you found out that he's immature, what you want to do is just, you know what, that's it, I'm not taking this anymore. Because at the end of the day, what will happen is, by the time he gets mature, by the time he gets to a place where he now has values, where he wants to have a committed relationship, he will leave you and meet and get involved and get settled down with someone that he will really appreciate and love. So what you would have done all those times is that you would have wasted your time, you would have wasted your energy, you would have wasted all your emotions for nothing. You have gone through heartbreak for no reason. Okay, so you want to stay away from someone that is immature. And the final reason I'm going to talk about today is the fact that the love is just gone. The relationship has already ended. Okay, I know that a lot of times, especially as Africans, especially for me that's from Nigeria, we want to keep our relationships, we want to make it work, we want to do everything we can to make it work. In terms of relationship, in terms of marriage, the same goes. Okay, you want to keep your relationship because of the fact that, okay, it's been a long time you've been together with this guy, or maybe because you've been married to this guy, you don't want this relationship to break, or you don't want this marriage to break. You stay in this relationship even though you know that this guy is cheating on you, but the relationship is dead. The love is gone. The guy doesn't love you anymore. The marriage is dead, and you still go ahead. At the end of the day, it will still break. So why would you want to kill yourself? Why would you want to hurt yourself so much and stay in a relationship that the relationship is already dead? I mean, I remember being in a relationship some years ago, and this guy began to cheat. Okay, so, and when a guy starts cheating on you, you would always know. You would know the signs. The signs would be there, but because you love him and you trust him so much, you might not want to believe it. And what I did, because I was so young, I was trying to get to his phone, trying to do this, trying to do that, trying to sneak up on him when he's when he's having telephone conversations, just to try and hear what he was saying. at the end of the day, I was almost giving myself hypertension, to be honest. You know, so it was really, really bad. But at the end of the day, the relationship still didn't work out, because when someone cheats on you once, there's a tendency that he's going to do it again and again and again and again. And that is not good for your mental health. That's not good for your physical health. That's not good for you at all. Okay. But the relationship, anyway, so it's something to look back to and just laugh about, because then I was young and naive. So it's something I can laugh about now. But believe me, at the time, it wasn't funny at all. But what I wanted to know as a lady is that if a man cheats on you, it's not your fault. It's not because you're not a good person. It's not because you're not perfect. He saw you that way when he came to you. It's not because you've done something wrong. But the number one reason is because he has character defect. So a man that has character defect will go ahead and cheat on you, even though he knows that something is wrong. Even though he knows that what he's doing is wrong. Even though he knows that he's going to hurt you, he will do it because he has character flaws. He cannot control himself. He's not disciplined enough to control himself to say, you know what, I can't do this because I love this person. Another reason why a man would cheat on you is because he can. He knows that he can. He thinks that he can get away with it. Everyone is doing it, so why not? Why won't I do it? Okay, so that's another reason. A man would cheat on you because he's immature. He doesn't understand what it means to have a committed relationship. He doesn't know what it is to be committed in a relationship. He doesn't know that he's hurting you. Even though he knows he's hurting you, he still goes ahead to do it because he's immature. Okay, and the only thing that's it's on your side is the fact that you accept it and you take it because you think he's your last bus stop. Okay, but what you want to do is place value on yourself. Have values to say, you know what, I can't take this anymore. This is not accepted in my relationship. And hopefully you'll be a better and a happier person for it. Okay, so these are just a few tips for me, what I think the reasons why men cheat are. If you have any other reason, please leave them in the comment section and I'll be happy to look into them. I hope you like this video. If you do, give this video a thumbs up, please comment, share, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video.